Okay, let's say a little prayer before we start our day. Let us thank God for the lovely things He has given us.
God's love is so wonderful. God's love is so wonderful. God's love is so wonderful. Oh, wonderful love. So high, you can't get over it. So deep, you can't get under it. So wide, you can't get around it. Oh, wonderful love.
Let us sing it again. For all that He has given us.
He makes a way where there seems no way. Jehovah. art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not to temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Bless our verses. This is the day that the Lord has made, that we will all rejoice and be glad in it. As you welcome teacher Esther to come and take us through. Welcome.
Thank you. Hi, children.
Hi.
Let's say hi to the children back at home.
Hi.
We thank God because of this day that He has given unto us. We don't take it for granted, for it has taken His mercies and His might for us to be healthy, alive, this particular moment. And before we start and read our readings today, I want us to just remind ourselves, during this pandemic time in our country and also in the whole world, what are the healthy habits that we should adhere to help us protect ourselves from contracting these deadly diseases?
Wash our hands regularly with clean water.
Yes, we are true. We should wash our hands regularly with clean water and soap. Washing our hands regularly with clean water. Something else that we should adhere to? Yes, Leah? Yeah, we should observe social distancing so that we are not close to one another. What else are we supposed to do? Yes, Charles? Yeah, make sure you wash your hands very well. Even the children who are back at home, make sure your hands are clean when you are from maybe outside. You have touched maybe surfaces from all over the places that you've gone. Make sure your hands are clean. Something else?
Wash our hands to prevent germs.
Yeah, we are washing our hands to prevent getting those germs. The moment you use clean water and soap, if maybe there are some germs on your hands, they will be removed by the detergent or the soap or the sanitizer. Remember, you sanitize when you are starting the lesson. Something else that is very key and we are supposed to observe is to eat healthy. Make sure you eat balanced diet. Make sure you eat greens, vegetables, so that we can boost our immunity. Remember, this disease is affecting, or else it is becoming so severe to those people that have low immunity. Low immunity, for example, the elderly and the younger children. So we should observe what we are taking or eating. So educate those other, even those other children, educate one another, remind one another to take balanced diet, to take vegetables. Don't tell one another that I don't like sukuma wiki, I don't like spinach. This is the time, this is the duration that we should love these vegetables more. Now, our topic today is about forgiveness. It is about
forgiveness.
Who can tell us what forgiveness is? Jeremy, Natalia?
Forgiveness is when somebody does wrong to you, but then you just forget it and become friends with them.
Yeah, it is when someone does something wrong to you, and you just, instead of living with the pain, you make that hard decision to forgive and to say to your friend or whoever has done something wrong to you and forgive them. Just like God forgave us our sins. Now we are going to read Romans chapter 12, verse 19. Leah will read for us.
Romans chapter 12, verse 19 says, "Do not take revenge, my friends, but leave room for God's wrath. For it is written, 'It is mine to forgive, and I will repay,' says the Lord."
Yeah. Let's pray for her. Romans 12, verse 19 says, "Do not revenge. Don't take revenge." In the world that we are living today, people will do bad things to you. Someone will take your book. Someone will take your pencil. And it is upon you, it's God's command for us to forgive those people that are doing wrong things to us. And instead of holding the pain and living with it, we are advised or guided or commanded by the word of God to forgive that person that has done something wrong to us. Why are we forgiving? So that we can live a peaceful life. Anytime that you hold grudge, anytime that you don't want to forgive those people that are hurting you on a daily basis, you have a burden in your heart. And there are consequences of holding on grudges. There are consequences. Anyone of you who knows the consequences of holding on to grudges? For example, you may get yes, if you do something wrong because you want to revenge on someone, then you will be punished. And again, even health-wise, if you hold on, you live with pain, you don't want to forgive, you are mad at every other person, you will be prone to diseases. For example, ulcers. Because you will not be able to eat because you are angry, someone did something wrong to you, and you will end up messing your life and shortening your life for that matter. Something else is that even psychologically, you will not be sober. You'll be someone who is stressed all over, mentioning the names of all those people that have done something wrong. During this period, our schools have been closed. We are at home. We have our phones. I understand nowadays children have phones. We have our balls at home. We have our bikes. For instance, if someone destroys your bicycle, Jeremy, or a chance, you are supposed to forgive that friend of yours or that other child from your estate. Because it is not, if at all they were aware of what they were doing, he or she would not have destroyed your bicycle. But that is not, it is not worth to hold on to grudge to each and every person who does something wrong to you. Forgiveness is for God. God is the one who forgave us first. He sent his only begotten Son to come and die because of our sins. Jesus Christ suffered. He was harassed by people in the world, crucified, but yet he said, "I forgive them." So we are following what Jesus Christ did to forgive. In our prayer, Heavenly Father, we are instructed to forgive those who do what? Those who wrong us. Just as Christ forgave us. So I want us to live by this. Because we are going to encounter so many things in the world and wherever we are living. We are going to see children doing wrong things. Let us advise one another. Don't live with the pain. Forgive her. Be ambassadors. Talk to other children at home. Talk to your neighbors. Don't allow them to hold on to grudges. Remind them that forgiveness is for? Forgiveness is for who? For God. He commands us to forgive all the people that wrong us. And remember that we are also not saints. We are not saints. We are sinners also. So we forgive other people so that we can also be forgiven. There's a verse from Ephesians 4:2, which is our memory verse today. And it says, be kind to one another. Be kind to one another. Be tender-hearted, forgiving each other, just as God in Christ also has forgiven you. So forgiveness comes along, is hand in hand with being kind and tender-hearted. Live peacefully with each and every person you meet or you interact with. Be cautious, be keen what you tell them. Be sensitive to what you do to them so that they can also try and copy what you are doing. People will just wonder, Leah cannot abuse me. and she'll tell me, I'll just forgive you because I don't want so many things and so many arguments. So one day, that person will have to think and just have a soul searching. It is called unaketi unajiuliza maswali. Why is this person behaving this way? I've done this, I've done so many things to her, but she still has the courage to talk to me, to do good things to me, and she has no ill motive at all. And they will be pulled towards your faith and what you practice. Is it in order? Yeah, so we live peacefully with those people that are around us and also maybe that we are going to interact with in future. What does forgiveness do? Forgiveness encourages good relationships. And anytime you have nothing to hold about regarding someone, definitely you will have good relationships with everyone. Even those people that are termed in quotes as bad people. Watu watakuwa wanashangaa, huyu ni mbaya sana but Alexis can deal with this person. How does she do it? You will interact with anyone because you have no grudges inside you. And by doing this, by doing what? Forgiving, we will be doing God's will on earth. God's will on earth is for us to live peacefully and to have good relationships with everyone. God does not love revenge. God does not love arguments, holding grudges. He does not love that. He loves peaceful people. Who can see someone going to maybe there is a hole here. Someone who can see there is a hole here, and you tell us not to pass through this route, even if he has done something wrong to you. So, yeah. So we are going to memorize our memory verse for today. Let it be your verse each and every morning. And this way we are going to have very peaceful life, good relationships, and we will have healthy lives because we are not going to get sick from diseases that are brought about by holding a lot of pain in our hearts. Believers, like us, we must be willing to forgive others. So, just see, our topic today is just revolving around forgiving those other people, a believer. Forgiveness coming from God, not revenging. And the verse that Claire read for us from Romans 12:19. We are told not to hold a place of wrath. For it is who will revenge for us?
God.
Who will revenge for us?
God.
It is God who will revenge for us. Not us. That is his work. Someone has done something wrong, you just forgive. If at all there is any revenge or vengeance that will be done, we leave it to
God.
To the Most High God. So I thank you all because of listening carefully. And I pray that we are going to live and abide to what we have learned today, that is forgiveness. And before we close, we are going to memorize our memory verse for today. And what does it say? Be kind to one another, tender-hearted, forgiving each other, just as God in Christ has also forgiven you. Ephesians 4, 32. Be kind to one another, tender-hearted, forgiving each other, just as God in Christ has also forgiven you. And now we are going to God and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us now and forevermore. Amen. Let's wave children back at home. Goodbye.